It's fantastic to have you tonight. You're looking forward to the film?
Very much so, yeah. Very excited. I was seeing James and Fassbender.
Are you a big X-Men fan? Is it a franchise that you followed?
It's not a franchise I've followed particularly, but I'm kind of up for those types of films. I'm trying to be diplomatic now. There's easy watchers.
I mean, the superhero genre has really exploded in the last few years. Is it something you've ever been interested in, something you'd fancy for yourself at some point?
I remember, actually, a long, long time ago, I auditioned to play Superman, as did every other adult male in London. Yes, it would be a lot of fun. Bowling about on green screen, pretending you have powers you don't possess. I'm up for that.
And if you were to have one power, what would you most want?
God, I should have known you were going to ask this. I should have known. I'm going to probably say time travel.
Talking about your real life powers, your awesome acting powers, what are you using those for at the moment? Coming up next for you in 2014.
I've just come to the tail end of a film with Kelsey Grammer. So we're just finishing up, tying up the loose ends of that, called Breaking the Bank, which is a comedy about the banking collapse in the city. And then in a couple of weeks, I've got the beginning of the third series of Bad Education, which I do with Jack Whitehall.
Starting, I mean, talking about working with Kelsey, I mean, what's that been like? I mean, obviously a small screen legend in so many ways.
Yeah, a small screen legend, and it's bizarre to work with somebody. I mean, you know, I've been very fortunate enough to work with a lot of really amazing people who have huge renown across the world. But Kelsey was one I could never have predicted. And he was extraordinary, yeah. Amazing man, very professional and very lovely. And although I think, you know, he was doing the film just to have a little bit of a holiday in England. He's very, very funny, and it was great fun, yeah.
Talking about funny, what are you looking forward to about the third season of Bad Education? Because your character, he's a bit of a buffoon on that, really, to be honest.
Yeah, I mean, we've got the read-through on Friday, and I haven't seen any scripts. All I know from the producer is that my various costumes, because I was like a prawn in the last series, and like an elf, my costumes get worse. So that should be both exciting and demeaning in equal measure.
Is there anything else on the horizon, or is that it for now?
Well, that will finish as summertime. Then I'll have a little summer break, and then hopefully into the theatre, although that's not confirmed yet. Trying to do a play a year.
We love seeing you on stage. Why do you keep coming back to it? What is it you get from that you don't get from screen work?
Working down the road from my house. You get an instant reaction from the audience every night, and people always say to me about filming is that, you know, does it not get repetitive having to do take after take and stuff like that? Of course, I don't have to do a lot of takes. They try to. And it's kind of the opposite, really, because they say on stage, how do you do the same thing every night, you know? And it's completely different every night, because you've got a completely different set of people in the room, if people have come. And so the whole atmosphere is different. So although you're saying the same lines and playing the same part that you've rehearsed for several weeks, it's completely different, and that's what's exciting. So, yeah, I love being on stage, and you know, it's an important part of my career, really, to keep doing that.